So this week we will turn our attention to a specific class of algorithms for matching strings. So quite a lot of our computation these days deals with text. So most of our interactions with computers is in terms of word processors or searching the internet. So we are constantly typing text and we are manipulating text. And searching for a string in a piece of text is a fundamental operation in all these. For instance, if you have a text editor and you want to replace some erroneous text by some correct text, you need to find all occurrences of the text that you want to replace. Or if you make actually a query in a search engine, then what the search engine is trying to do is to take the query that you have put in as a piece of text and find all the documents that it has in its indexed database which match that piece of text. And we've already seen applications outside this conventional text processing. For instance, in genetics, you might want to look for a particular gene sequence in some string of DNA. So in all of these cases, we have a pattern of text which we want to compare against some given text and find out if there is a match or not. So if you look at this formally, first let's look at it informally. So if you look at, for instance, the pattern to be the word AN, right? And we have a text, which in our case here is just a small word banana. So we want to find out where all it matches. So we would find, for instance, that it matches here. So there is the first AN which appears right after the B. And then there is one more match after that. So there are two positions where this pattern matches this piece of text. So a general question we could ask is, given a piece of text and given a pattern which is another piece of text, and in general we will assume that this pattern is not empty, because if it is empty, of course it makes no sense to match it. So let's assume that we have a non-empty pattern and we have some non-empty text. So the text will be of some length n, there will be n characters, the pattern will be of length m, and of course m has to be smaller than n. If you have a longer pattern than the piece of text, if I look for banana in the word an, I will not find it. So you can assume that m is less than n for sure. Right? And usually we will assume that it is much smaller. I mean, for instance, you type a search query in a search engine, it will be a few words. You are searching for documents which contain hundreds of words. So usually the length of the pattern we can assume is much smaller than the length of the document. So we are really interested in doing something which is kind of optimized in both these quantities. So these letters that we use come from some set of symbols which is usually called an alphabet. So this Greek letter capital sigma usually denotes the set of valid characters which I will encounter in this search. Now in most of our day-to-day use, we deal with the characters we can type on the keyboard, but you can imagine that you can do it on different languages or over different symbol sets. So some of the algorithms, there may be a dependence on what the size of this alphabet is. So if it comes up, we will refer to it explicitly using sigma. So the search problem that we are really interested in is to find every match. So since we assume that the pattern is of length m, we are looking at these slices of length m in our text. So start at a position I and go up to I plus m minus 1. So that is a slice I colon I plus m. We want to check which all slices of this form match p, and we would like to report every such I. So every I, so in particular, if we had a piece of text where patterns overlap, for instance, we have AAA as our text and we have two A's as our pattern, so this is my pattern and this is my text, right? Then you would report position 0, because at position 0 there is a match for my pattern, but you would also report position 1, because at position 1 also if I start looking at the slice of length 2, I have a match for my pattern. So these positions need not be disjoint, right? So we want every I so that the slice of length m starting at I matches p. So there is a very natural brute force way to do it, which is to just look at every slice starting from I and compare the letters one by one. Now of course in Python you could write this as something like this, right? You could just compare as strings whether the slice of length m starting from ti is equal to the pattern p. But this equality here hides, of course, an implicit search character by character. So to make it explicit, when we use our code here, we will not use string equality, we will just use letter-wise equality and write our explicit loops. So what we have here now is a loop, right? So we start, first of all, we are going to report all the positions. So we need to keep track of all the positions in the list which we initialize to be empty. And if I am going to look for a pattern of length m in my text, then it cannot start further than n minus m from the end, because if it is less than m characters from the end, then the pattern will not fit. So I need to go only up to length of the text minus the length of the pattern. So I start for every position from 0 to the length of the text minus the length of the pattern. And for starting from there, I initially assume that the slice matches. So I have a Boolean matched, which I assume is true, which says that I have not found a mismatch in this slice yet. And I start with the first position in the slice, which is I plus j is going to be, I'm going to go from I plus 0, I plus 1, I plus 2 up to I plus position length of p minus 1, or m minus 1. So I start with j equal to 0. So long as I'm within that slice and so long as I have not found a mismatch, I check the next position in the slice. So I check whether the text at I plus j is equal to the pattern at j. If at any point I find that the text at I plus j does not match the pattern at j, I immediately flag it, right? I say that the mismatch has occurred, so matched becomes false. And then I increment my j. So when I come back here, I have two options. Either I have finished the slice, so j has become length of p, or I have flagged a mismatch, so matched has become false. So when I come out of the loop, if I still have matched set to true, it must be that I reached the end of the pattern without finding a mismatch. So I can append the current starting position, which I started with right now, to my list of matched positions. And if matched is false, then I found a mismatch. So this I can be skipped and I can go to the next I, which is happening here in this for loop. Right? So this is a very natural left to right scan, position by position. And the only optimization we have done is that we have basically made sure that we come out of each slice as soon as we can. So whenever we find a mismatch, this while loop will exit. So in particular, if I have a text which looks like A, B, C, D, E, and my pattern looks like X, Y, right? Then the moment I look at A, B, I will say that A doesn't match X and I will quit. Then I look at B, C, I will look at A doesn't match, B does not match X and I will quit. So if there is no match at all between my pattern and my text, it will very quickly go through all the positions without going through the full slice of each position each time. Nevertheless, this is in general going to be bad because in general I would have a lot of overlap ending with a mismatch. So I could have, for instance, a text which has n A's, right, and a pattern which has m minus 1 A's plus a B. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to, for each slice, I'm going to first look at the first m minus 1 letters and believe there is a match. And then when I reach the last letter, I find there is a mismatch and only then do I get out of the loop. So for each of these will actually go through the entire length of the pattern before it finds a mismatch. So in general, I'm going to have a complexity of n times m. So it's actually, we remember that it doesn't actually go to n, it goes to n minus m. But since m is small, we can assume that the number of positions we scan, starting positions we scan, is order n. And for each of those, we are going through the slice of length m. So this is the trivial complexity for a brute force algorithm. Now we can do a simple modification of this, which is also brute force, but the only thing is that instead of, so when we scan the slice I to I plus m, right? So we were scanning it from I to I plus m. We could also scan it in reverse. Right? So this is a reverse string match. So the only difference comes here. So we initialize j to be the last position in the slice, right? And we go backwards, right? So otherwise there's no change. So if you compare this code with the previous code, right, you will find that the only difference is j equal to 0, j equal to j plus 1, and the while condition j less than length of p is matched to j equal to length p minus 1, j greater than equal to 0, and j equal to j minus 1. So all we are saying is that we are processing t from left to right, but each slice within t we are processing from right to left. Okay, so there's no difference, of course, this is still order mn. So this kind of a thing we would find quickly if we are doing right to left, because the very first character from the right will mismatch. But if we correspondingly put a bad string which starts with the first character having a mismatch, then we do it right to left, again we spend order m time before we find the match or the mismatch. So this will also be order mn. So why are we bothering with this? I mean, why would reversing the scan be of any use? Because it just looks like a different version of the brute force. So we can, it turns out, speed things up. So supposing that while we are matching, we find a letter in the text which does not match any letter in the pattern. So for instance, supposing our text is this word banana mania, right? And the pattern is bulk. So if I scan from left to right, then at this point, my first slice, for instance, B matches. And then the first mismatch I find is at the second position. At this position, I find the letter A in my text and the letter U in my pattern. Now, A does not appear anywhere in my pattern. So, there is no way that bulk can overlap with that position where A is, because there is no letter in my pattern which can match the A. So, what we can do is, in this situation, we can skip the next scan. The next scan would have been to start bulk from the position A, but we already know that the position A is useless. So, we can take our pattern and go past it, right? So, we can directly skip one position and go and start at the third position. Suppose instead we were doing our reverse scan. So, we have the same situation, but now we start from the right and we find a mismatch with the last letter, which is again an A, against our K, which has the is the last position in bulk. So, once again we know that A does not occur. So, it does not matter what is before that, we know that we have to shift this entire word after the A, because there is no point in trying any of these intermediate things, because all of them would overlap this A. And if I overlap an A, it cannot match my pattern, because my pattern does not have an A anywhere. So, in this case, I would actually shift it to the right by 3 positions rather than by 1 position, right. So, therefore, we could have a faster skipping if we are using this kind of a heuristic to speed up our search, because when we see a letter which is in our text but not in our pattern, then we can actually fast forward in some sense the scan, right. So, this is one special case of what is an optimization called the Boyer-Moore algorithm, which we shall look at next.